Hello friends, welcome to the D.El.Ed program of EVS. I am Dr. Romila Soni from Department of Elementary Education, NCERT, New Delhi. Today's program topic is Program Solving in EVS. Now let's see what is the focus of this session. The unit is 6.9 and focus of the session is what is program problem solving method? What are the different methods for EVS learning? Why do we need child-centered methods? And what are the process skills in EVS learning? We are going to learn some more things about program solving method. Need of program solving in EVS classroom. Why do we need of problem solving in EVS classroom? Steps of problem solving method. Examples of problem solving method. What are the benefits of problem solving method and how it is appropriate for EVS classroom? And what are the challenges associated with problem solving method? What is problem solving method? Let's take one by one. Problem solving is also called problem-based learning. It is a method aimed to help the children in arriving at a solution or alternative solutions for a given problem. For example, if you give a problem to a child, encourage the child to give alternative solution instead of only one solution. If I'll give you a very, very simple example, if I'll ask a child, when you're coming from home to the school and if your slipper or the shoes gets broken, in what different ways you can mend your shoes or mend your slipper? This is a very simple problem. The expected answer from a child may be he will look for a cobbler. But again, in case the cobbler is not there, then what the child will do? Can he think about other solutions? Yes. For example, the child can say, I will use a safety pin to mend my slipper temporarily. I can tie a handkerchief. So let the child think about alternative solutions for a given problem. This is a very simple problem. According to the age level of the child, provide the complex problem and encourage children to do critical thinking and give alternative solutions for a given problem. Problem solving should be a part of the primary school curriculum, definitely. It keeps and it makes the brain active. And problem solving is a very, very important process skills of EVS. Children can take on some of the responsibility for their own learning and can take personal action. It is a life skill also. To solve problems, children get competent to solve problems because they say, agar ek solution se problem solve nahi hoti hai, toh we can use another solution. Even if usse bhi nahi hoti hai, toh we can try another solution. So such children who are able to solve problems are not frustrated children. They are ready to take challenges and they are more calm and composed children. So that's why we say it is also a life skill. Resolve conflicts. Problem solving technique help children to solve conflicts on their own. Problem solving method helps children to discuss the alternatives. Ye nahi to aur kuch, ye nahi to aur kuch. So we can try. So children keep on trying to reach to a solution. It also helps children to focus on thinking as a vital element of the EVS curriculum. So in short, it is a very, very important process skill. Need of the child-centered method. We need to see that whatever we are giving in the classroom has to be child-centered. All the methods, all the methodologies need to be child-centered because children are active participants in their own education and development. This means that they should be mentally involved and physically active in learning what they need to know and do. So, activeness mentally and activeness physically, both are important. Need of child-centered method. Again, we need to see that why we continuously say that classrooms need to be child-centered. We need to focus on child-centered methods because children have a natural curiosity about their world and how it works. If you see a simple example, children want to know how it works. They want to see, isko khol ke dekho, ye kaise khulta hai, ye kaise band hota hai. So that is because there is an innate curiosity in them and which is need to be nurtured by the teachers and by all the adults who are concerned with the education of the children. Encourage children to do guessing. Encourage children to do predictions. This keeps their process skills active and they learn better by the process than by the final product. Even as a teacher, you need to focus on the process skills of the children rather than the final product, because process is more important. How the child is learning is more important rather than usne ant mein kya banaya, kaisa banaya. Usse jyada important. So it should be process oriented rather than result oriented. Children constantly wonder, they constantly explore, they examine, they describe, they manipulate, they compare and question things relating to the natural environment. So we need to see, if we know that children are constantly wondering, exploring, examining, describing, manipulating the material, we need to create the classroom environment in such a way that it becomes a stimulating environment to focus on all these things and making the learning easier, stimulating and interesting for all the children. So we need to remember these are the characteristics of children, and that's why we need to keep our methodologies, keep our pedagogies and practices child-centered. Process. We keep on focusing on that the process in EVS and science is much more important, whatever product may result. So if you'll see in a picture, the child is looking at the nest and trying to depict that nest on his paper. How his drawing is not important and why he gets so much attracted towards the nest, because he went outside with his friends along with his teacher outside. There the teacher and the children saw an empty nest and they brought it back to the classroom. So this is a part of your concept. This is the part of your planning process. So going to the nature walk with your lens, with your basket, and bringing back some of the materials which you see on the way during your concept and topic. And then talking about that particular things. For example, if you bring leaves, you can do classification, you can do sorting, you can do seriation. So here the child has brought a beautiful nest to the classroom. So the process is important, how the child is looking at the nest, what the child is understanding by looking at the nest, how the child is drawing, what understanding he is grasping from the nest is more important. Rather than usne ant mein drawing kaise banai. It's not that if the teacher will comment, ye tumne kaisa nest banaya hai. Nest aisa to nahi dikh raha. So rather commenting on the final product, look at the process, how the child is learning, how the child is making connections. So making connections in the children's learning is very, very important. So process, how the child is solving a problem, how the child is observing, how the child is communicating while talking about the nest. So that is more important. What are the other process skills? As a teacher, you must know the process skills. Observation. How the child is observing. You need to prepare lots of activities where the children get opportunities to explore and to observe the objects and the nature around him. Questioning. As we keep on saying, provide lots of opportunities to the children to ask questions and also provide opportunities to the children to answer questions. So why is very important. Communicating. talking about, discussing, interaction with the peers, with the adults, classifying, sorting things, sorting leaves, sorting pebbles, sorting seeds, sorting animal pictures. There are so many things. Comparing. This is different from this. This is small than this. Measuring. Inferring. Reasoning out. And predicting. Predating, guessing. If you'll give a bucket to a child and ask, how many mugs of water are required to fill this particular bucket? The child may say, 30 mugs. That is a prediction. That is a guess. Then you can actually ask the children, okay, now come on. Ab karke dekhte hain, kitne mug pani dalenge, to ye balti bharegi. Now, then you can ask the child, what is the difference between what you guessed and when you actually fill the bucket with the water? So, karke seekhna, behtar seekhna. Process skills in EVS are very important in the formal presentation of EVS to children. It makes the children confident. It makes the grasping of the concepts better. And it makes the learning faster. Importance of process skills. Why the process skills are very important? Well, the children who are properly introduced through process skills will find the skills useful throughout life. They may forget the theory. They may forget what they have read. But they will never forget what they have manipulated with their hands. They will never forget when they do hands-on experiences and handle objects and materials. As we say, while it is easy to forget the content learned, but process skills tend to remain for a relatively longer period. And in most of the cases, lifetime. Need of problem solving. So we continue to talk about why problem solving method is important. It provides children with many opportunities for hands-on experiences which make them confident to use their newly acquired knowledge in meaningful real-life activities and assist them in working at higher level of thinking. So starts from simple and move to complex. What are the steps to problem solving? So we need to see that we have to focus on particular steps. Problem solving method is based on and focuses on an identified environmental issue or a problem. So when you give the problem to a child, encourage children to discuss and identify what is the issue and give them a time. But then also you need to see that time management is again a very important thing. So these are the very important steps in problem solving method. When you're going to plan activities for your children related to any concept and any theme. First is identification, explaining, fact finding, analyzing, discussing the possible strategies, and finally, evaluating the results. Identification of a problem. What is an issue? And then explaining. Explain that particular problem in detail. Discussing. Fact finding. Aisa kyun hua? Agar aisa hua, toh let's find out aur kaise ho sakta hai. Analyzing. Discussing the possible strategies. What could be the possible strategies? We are going to see some examples related to the steps in problem solving, which will help you to understand each of the steps better. Evaluation. So when you did the discussion, when you try to solve a problem, then finally you have to evaluate your results. The discussion group approach. Identify, understand, and describe the problem. So take any issue, identify it, try to understand what that problem is about and describe the problem. Teachers should intervene only when children need it. Every time standing at the head of the children is not correct. So demonstrate one activity, one problem, and then encourage children to do it in the small grow. And whenever there is a need, children is always there as a scaffolder and as a facilitator. Explain the problem. For this, the children may need to research, gather information which is related to the identified problem. Fact finding. If required, do the field work. If they wanted to know something about the plants, take children outside to observe variety of plants. Let them do a survey of outside. Let them observe the different types of trees. Let the children do experiment under your supervision. Encourage them to do a discussion where you are there as a scaffolder, as a facilitator, and you may even plan a project. You may plan a project on types of plants in my immediate surroundings. Plan a project. So when we say that you need to see that each and every child participate, it's not that ki jo bachcha jyada bolta hai, aap usko hi question karne ka aur answer karne ka mauka dete hain. You need to see that every child participate in a discussion. The purpose of problem solving method is also opening up every child in a small group discussion. It will also help the shy and quiet children. And do this activity in a very relaxed manner. Encourage children to discuss. Do not snub any child. Ask questions. Encourage children to ask questions. Comment on children's work. Think of several solutions and then make predictions. Ho sakta hai ye aisa ho. I guess it'll work like this. I guess. Okay, you guess this. Now let's do actually. So this will help the children to open up when you allow them to speak and do the predictions. Here again, like if you plan a project, for example, a grocery store. So that's your project. So this is a concept and where you encourage children to do discussion on people in their jobs, different kinds of food, how food is kept fresh, machine used at the store, how customers buy food, where food comes from, how food gets to the store. So this is a discussion. And you can take any one issue and start discussing on that particular issue. Again, analyzing the problem. When you have the data, when you have collected the data, now interpret it. What it is saying actually. Interpret it, usko samajna. Ye data keh kya raha hai? Now we have so much of information. Now you have to interpret the data. Discuss to arrive at a solution. An alternative solution. Never depend on one solution. Maybe that solution will not work. So you should have at least 4 to 5 alternative solutions. Ye kaam nahi karega, to ye. So you have alternative strategies. Discussion helps to arrive at the most plausible solution. So we say that discussion with your colleague also helps. Then discuss the possible strategy for action. When you have discussed in depth, develop an action plan to solve the problem. Action plan, how you're going to execute it. The approach used may vary. It depends upon the situation and the groups or the teams you have developed. Finally, after making an action plan, now this is the time to evaluate the results. After a solution has been reached, it is important to evaluate the results to determine if it is effective in solving the given problem. Doesn't matter if it doesn't work because you have already made 4 to 5 alternative solutions. So if one will not work, another, we can try another. So you are also developing indirectly an attitude in the child, yes, I can. So such children will never get frustrated. So let's see one activity for problem solving. Ask your children to do the following. Ask your children to list major environmental problems faced by you and the people of your locality. Rank these problems according to your priority. Draw up a table with the headings problem. Actions which could be taken by people and action to be taken by the government. Let's try to understand that you have to draw up a table where you are going to make a heading, problems, and then actions which could be taken by the people and actions that can be taken by the government. compare and discuss your table with your classmates. Write one thing for each problem that you could do to solve it. Then ask your children to compare their list by writing some of the major problems on the board, that is the blackboard. Then actions to be taken on the part of the members of society may be highlighted and stressed upon. So that's your results. What is the message we are getting through this activity? The message that every individual through his or her actions can contribute to the protection of environment and conservation of resources needs to be emphasized upon. So it's so easy. In problem solving method, when you encourage children to do the discussion and evaluate their result, their understanding becomes so easy. They come to understand that, okay, that is the problem and now we have got the solution to this problem. What are the benefits of problem solving method? Well, it develops an insight into environmental problems. It facilitates divergent thinking among children. It brings real life issues in the classroom. They can relate it to the real life issues. It makes children deal with open-ended, complex environment development scenarios. It helps children appreciate multiple views on the same issue. But then there are certain challenges also in the problem-solving method. What are these? Clarity of concept. Many times, if the concept or the theme is not clear to the children, they cannot discuss, they cannot reach to some conclusion, and it remains a problem for them. So clarity of concept is very, very important. If the children does not have a clarity on how to plan the discussion and how to go step by step to solve the problem, then again it becomes a challenge for the children. So they cannot arrive to any conclusion or solution. Another challenge can may be for the teacher and for the children both, how to organize the discussion approach for problem solving method. So practice makes a man perfect. So you can try it and let the children do it in a small group and encourage children to open up. If you are snubbing the children not to speak this, not to speak this, then the children cannot discuss it and you cannot realize the hidden potential in each child. How to lead the discussion? In the beginning, teacher should always demonstrate and lead the discussion for problem solving method. When the children got into the practice and they know how they are going to do about, then let them do it independently in a small group. You can also do it in a buddy system, but small group approach is always better. What are the techniques which will help the children in problem solving method? Encourage them to list all related relevant facts. Make a list of all the given information. Ask children when they are working in a small group for problem solving method, ask them to make a list. Listing is very, very important. Restate the problem in their own words. Although you have given them their problem, but encourage children to restate the problem in their own words. List the conditions that surround a problem. Describe related known problems. Begin with the familiar and then proceed to unfamiliar. What should be the role of the teacher in this problem solving method? Discover the interest of the children. When you begin with where the children's interest lies, it becomes easy for the children to understand the discussion approach and the problem solving method, because वो बच्चे के रुचि का क्षेत्र है. Encourage children to use many strategies. Give children opportunities to engage in some trial and error approach to problem solving. It makes children confident. Encourage children to create visual mental images. Understand the children's viewpoint. What do we mean by visual mental images? Before actually doing the problem solving method in a discussion approach in a small group, ask children to think about what do they think about this problem. Then ask them to do it actually in a small group and listen to each child's viewpoint. Never try to throw your viewpoint onto the child. Try to see the situation from the student's viewpoint as well. Provide multiple opportunities to children to assess their own problem-solving skills. And most important is, work towards the strength of each child. Each child is unique and each child is important. If we summarize what we have done till now, teachers need to help, guide, moderate, and orient children's thinking and facilitate the exchange of ideas. The discussion during problem solving can be analyzed by various techniques: leading the discussion, finding the facts, evaluating and judging what others say, checking their suggestions and ideas, and finally making, delegating, or thwarting decisions. See this activity. There are things like sugar, salt, lemon juice, soap water, flour, dal, sharbat, cooking soda, oil, mustard oil, or any other. This is a problem for the child. You may ask, what can be dissolved in a water? That is mixed. What did not dissolve in a water? And if I'll put sugar in a water, does the color of the water changes? What could not be seen in a water? So first, let the children do it in a concrete manner, means with material. After they do it with the material and with all these objects and materials, then provide this worksheet. List down and jot down your results. Problem solving in a simple manner can be given in this way also. This we popularly known as crossword puzzle. So this is a simple which you can give it to the grade 1 students. That's the same thing. And there is another where you can also do it with the vegetables, like the way you do it with the what is dissolvable and what is not dissolvable. So when we are concluding this session, how problem solving makes us more important. We learn best when we discover the answer for ourselves. We learn best when we answer against other potential answers. We learn best when we find different ways of arriving at the same answers. So thank you so much. I hope you have enjoyed the session.